Hey, lady, I'll give you $20 for blowing the car.
You filthy, degenerate rapscallion! I'm not a prostitute!
What? No, I mean I need someone sober to blow into this breathalyzer they got hooked up to my ignition. Car won't start otherwise.
I'm not helping a drunk driver! It's Gatsby all over!
Come on, just one blow. I only had a few. Dozen. Rusty nails.
Calloused gadabout!
You saying I got syphilis? Yeah, hell with you, hell with you then. I'll find someone else. come here, kitty. Let go of my ear.
You salacious sacks of seagull shit! I'm Highwayman Tom Goose, and I'm here to rob you.
Kevin asked Allen what his friggin' problem was.
I'm here to take something away from you, boy. I'm here to rob you of your pain.
Kevin explained that as a violent sociopath, he didn't experience a lot of the usual emotional pain that typically tempers the growth of a behaviorally adjusted adult.
Oh, wake up already, boy! You ain't gonna live to adulthood!
Those crop circles! It's like a sign or something!
Jesus Christ, Percy! It's you! Were you driving drunk?
No way, I swear! Last thing I remember, we were just cruising around the prairies. Yay! The prairies!
Whoopee, more freaking prairies!
Jesus, it's boring. Can't there be a tornado or something?
Christ all fucking mighty! Enough with the goddamn prairies already! I'm going crazy! It's so god-awful boring! Boise, why don't you say something? Baby, what's wrong with your eyes?
I'm tired.
What?
I'm tired, and it's all a lot of fucking baloney.
What's baloney? What the hell are you talking about?
I'm tired. It's a lot of fucking baloney. I'm tired. It's a lot of baloney.
Boise, snap out of it.
I'm tired. I'm tired of the fucking baloney. Oh, ow. Thanks, babe. Holy frig, I guess I blew a gasket there. If we don't do something to stop being so bored, I'm gonna have to kill you people or something.
I know something that'll distract ya. Look out the window, boy. Mama's gonna help Daddy steer.
Oh, babe, let me put on some sexy music.
Well, then we had at her, and I guess we must have fell asleep or something.
Yeah, the prairies are pretty goddamn boring. I thought Percy was drunk at the wheel again. Thank goodness he was only being homicidally irresponsible.
Why are you being such a preachy prick? Go suck your bong before you tell me how to run my life, you pothead hippie.
Hey, that's not fair. I'm trying to cut down.
They're thinking of decriminalizing it. See, it's all over the news.
Welcome to Suspiciously Convenient News. Everyone's talking about decriminalization. The government is debating whether to waive the laws making it illegal to possess less than 30 grams of marijuana.
30 grams? That's a fluffy bag!
I don't like Percy smoking that stuff, on account it makes him impotent.
I find it helps me be creative.
Oh yeah, me too! Look at what I made out of straws the other day!
Jeez, even your statue's impotent! $50 says you can't quit smoking up!
What? Well, I guess I've been meaning to anyways, if I have to, Merde, why not? I'm gonna show you people! I'm gonna quit the stuff right now! I'll have my short-term memory back! I'll remember what it means not being paranoid all the time! I won't have to pay Hydro a million kilowatts for ultraviolet lamps! I'll do it! For 2 weeks, and I want to see the money up front.
Yes, start tomorrow!
Tomorrow? Whoa! I was thinking maybe next February or something.
Tomorrow!
Anastasia wasn't about to trust Charlie on a $50 bet, so she left Kevin to keep watch and make sure he didn't try and sneak off the wagon.
I appreciate you helping me, boy. You can be my sponsor. Let me show you around the property. Here's the old outhouse, but I don't use it much. I got plumbing in the trailer, so mostly I just loan it to your mom whenever there's a festival in town. Here's the old horse stables. I was thinking maybe we could fix them up together. It would be a joint venture. Yes, joint venture. Yeah, well, I guess I'll go smoke a joint and then we can get to work.
Kevin told Charlie he wasn't allowed to smoke up anymore.
Damn, you're right. I didn't even think about it. It was like a reflex. I'm really gonna need help. I better go smoke a joint and look through the phone book. I have a phone book around this joint somewhere. Join, join, join. Join, join, join. Boy, you're missing out on a perfect opportunity to wield some power. We got a chance to exercise your control demons, and a little exercise never hurt anyone. This demands finesse beyond your purulent, peckerhead, presumptuous pretense. Hey, Kevin, while I was cleaning up, I found this old roach, and I figured there'd be no harm if I smoked it. Wait. It's really a roach.
Kevin told Charlie he had a plan that would help him win his battle with addiction and the $50, which was way more important.
But Kevin, I really gotta use the little boys' room, dude.
After a few days, Kevin noticed that without the soporific delirium of THC, Charlie suddenly became too damn active.
Look at this, Kevin. I wrote 800 country songs last night, each one as good as the last. Listen. La la la, look at me, strumming my banjo, so happy. La la la, look at me, a brand new life, a brand new me. Ding dang dang and the dong dang do, dang digga dang dang digga dang do.
Hello there. We were wondering, what with all the decriminalization talk and all, if maybe we could see Mr. Blunt?
We've got some college friends coming over and thought, what a nostalgic blast if we had a pinch of Colombian. And I don't mean coffee.
Kevin, honest, I'm really feeling better now. I don't think you have to tie me up anymore.
Look, honey, it's just like you do to me every St. Patrick's Day.
Kevin told the McNaughtons that just because the stupid real world was decriminalizing pot didn't mean it should stand in the way of his friend's courageous fight against substance abuse.
Maybe we'll just come back another time.
Then Kevin told Charlie that he was just being weak and that he had nothing to worry about because his restraint system meant he'd be clean and sober in no time.
Well, okay, but I really do have to go to the bathroom again. Oops, sorry about the noise, but I'm a little bound up in here.
At 9, it's Talking to Canadians.
Do you know who the 19th president of the United States was?
Willie Nelson?
No, Rutherford B. Hayes, you nose-picking Canuck. Talking to Canadians. Join us next week when we ask, where does your country keep all of its fresh water? It'll be very interesting.
I give up.
I knew you couldn't handle it.
No, I mean, I can't do it alone. I'm going into rehab. Just keep that boy away from me.
We demand 4 clean urine tests a week, and there's a 9 p.m. curfew. Breach either of these terms, and you can jones in a ditch. We understand each other, right? Do you have any money?
If I had a lot of money, I'd still be out partying instead of in stupid rehab.
So Charlie attended a publicly funded rehab, and he found it really helped him focus, mostly on people who were trying to steal his stuff.
You got stuffed in your shirt, Bo.
I'm pregnant.
Oh, well, okay then.
Mr. Plant, you have a visitor.
Hey, Percy. Rehab's great, but you gotta keep an eye on your stuff or they rob you blind.
Here, I brought you some booze.
Jesus Christ, Percy, I can't touch anything. I have to dry out.
I kind of brought it hoping you'd say that.
Besides, I've discovered some of the less ephemeral distractions. Who needs drugs when you got these books on tape?
What's ephemeral? Does it make you high?
Letters to Forum, number 1. I never believed this would happen to me, but last Thursday, I received a large black double-dong dildo as a gift from my sorority sister, Jezebel. I've never used one of these, I gasped. The silk holding my ample bosom in restraint, heaving and dainty folds. Mm. Curious sexuality, is it, Lausch? Yes, sir.
Fuck, it was just getting to the best part.
Soup's up, junkies. You can eat it now or take it in pill form rectally. It's your choice.
Hey, Kevin. I'm just getting ready for my date with Timmy tonight. We're going to a goth party, so I had treble clefs painted on each fingernail, bought a backpack shaped like a coffin, and the pièce de résistance had all my teeth filed down to points. What do you think?
Kevin told Shauna he was too busy to listen to her cope with her market-fueled beauty myth inadequacies or neurotically dysmorphic body image.
Whatever.
Hey, boy. What do you want? What's that? Go with you to a deserted farmhouse in the woods? I don't know. You don't have a wood chipper or pigs or... Whoa. Okay, I'm coming. Just give me a sip, will you?
crawl. Listen to them. Their bodies screaming, crying out for something. But you're giving them a new life, boy. You're gonna take away their pain.
Since Charlie had escaped, Kevin realized he'd gotten a rush from the absolute control he'd enjoyed over him. So much so that he spent the next few days kidnapping homeless people, forcibly drying them out, and grooming them to his will. Soon he'd converted the rabble into a tightly knit citizens' militia that was totally obedient to his wishes. It was very fascist, which is why Kevin liked it.
Gentlemen, welcome to Fight Club!
Hang on! Hold, I can't get a fucking sip here!
That's it! You're no good, welfare junkie metal patients! I'm the premier of this province, and I'm here to tell you to get your asses off the public press and go get friggin' jacked!
My God, Mr. Premier.
Nice tits, baby!
Hilarious. You're a big fat drunk, telling these people they can't recover from booze, even though you're like the biggest drunk.
That's it. Get these drug addicts out of here so we can renovate this building into condominiums for drug dealers. They kicked everyone out of rehab because of cutbacks.
Don't like everybody else. Go to the States to get medical care quicker. That's how I scammed the government out of paying for my breast implants.
Yeah, except they put them on your ass.
I don't suppose anyone could cut me a lift to New York State.
He can't drive because of the breathalyzer on his car starter.
I got it covered. I've been breathing into a bag every time I'm sober. Thought I got a little stockpile of fresh breath with no liquor on it from last month. Check it out.
Maybe I better drive.
You ain't the publisher's sweepstakes.
Good evening, madam.
Who you calling madam?
Your son has been organizing an illegal citizens' militia. Some might call it a fight club.
Well, at least he joined the club. What the hell do you want me to do about it?
Where's the boy?
I don't know. I think that's him on the street corner over there. No, that's just someone with a black hat. No, how about the over? Whoa, that's weird.
What the hell?
Kevin's organization of brainwashed former alcoholics had become a bigger success than every other cult in the city. Even L. Ron Hubbard in Scientology. And they sure were weird.
What the hell? Should we shoot?
No. They're not doing anything. That's the point. He's daring us to shoot.
Who?
The boy. Let's bug out and regroup.
Don't fucking tell me.
Random check. Park the car with our search team and proceed to the kiosk with your documents.
Boy, I remember the old days. You'd have been nervous to go through the border.
Well, it's no hassles now, Percy. I'm getting clean and I got nothing to be ashamed of.
Yeah, you was always hiding something up your ass or under your hat. Remember that phony heel in your boot?
Yeah, I did some pretty crazy... Ugh, my boot. Ooh, that's right.
You're still holding? It's in your goddamn boot, ain't it, you bastard?
I kind of forgot about it. Did I mention what dope does to your short-term memory?
Well, that's just fucking beautiful.
Relax, Percy. It's just a few grams.
A few grand. The laws are different here, Charlie. As of now, I don't know you, fucker.
Percy, no. You gotta help me.
Okay. I got an idea. Slip me the stuff.
Thanks, Percy. I knew you were a pal. So tell me the plan and I'll... No, you made me eat it.
I tried it on some dog once. Oh, wait, that didn't work then either.
Anything to declare?
Yeah, I'm hung like a porn star and twice as intelligent.
Gentlemen, I'm only going to remind you once. You're entering the United States of America, and I will do whatever is necessary to protect her borders, her flag, and the Constitution for which she stands!
Sure, America's great, on paper. But you ain't fooling anyone, you know, like, you guys believe in any of that shit anymore.
Let's get this over with. What's his problem?
Time for my plan. He's just rehearsing for our jug band. Hit it, Charlie!
Sacrifice, I'm having an hallucination. Whoa, there's me when I was disco king.
Come on, Charlie. This disco shit's for losers. Everyone's punk now.
Your stomach being pumped and all, but I just wanted to tell you, you owe me $50, sucker!